Okay, so my second topic is world news or world story related around the world and not just America. And I'm trying to do this because I live in New York City and I'm in America. A lot of my viewpoints tend to be very America centric. So I really like to kind of broaden my perspective and kind of soak in whatever I can about things happening around the world. There is currently, I'm noticing this kind of, maybe it's been happening for a long time, but there is this kind of trend of banks becoming way too powerful in the world. And it's certainly the case in America, and I've recently read this, I guess, I don't know if it was an opinion piece, but it was some kind of news piece on New York Times, and it was talking about how Austria, as a country, is now trying to pass legislation that makes it okay for banks to be secretive with this money transactions and money handlings and loans that happen between and among other banks and other loan companies and such. It's now become like they're trying to make it, you know, banks are trying to be more secretive about it, and politicians and the laws behind it that are trying to form, laws that are being formed around that, are encouraging or empowering these banks to be able to do so. That's kind of the situation that, I mean, from what I've been reading, I might have been reading wrong, that's happening in Austria. There's also something like a month ago or 2 months ago, I watched it on like on Upworthy, which is a pretty interesting website. They like to promote videos that are, you know, not cool videos that they think everyone should watch, so they kind of bring those up. But it was a video in which it's in Ireland, I think it was in Ireland, but there is a group of bankers who are responding to people's questions. One Irish journalist asked the bankers like about their responsibilities of them having pretty much ruined the economy of Ireland. And the banker kind of sidestepped the issue of whatever. And, you know, the Irish journalist goes there and he's like, look, our taxpayer money is going to subsidize you guys. It's going to make sure that you don't fail so that the banks don't end up bankrupt and end up, you know, just destroyed. Why should our taxpayers' money be used to save you guys? That was like I think I'm paraphrasing there, but that was kind of like his line of questioning, and the banker couldn't answer that question because, you know, so this banking thing is happening around the world, this concept of too big to fail, which I think is a great quote or great little phrase that came up, because it's at this point it's kind of true. I mean, what the you know, I also, man, this is going back to a lot of the articles and videos that I've seen, but also on this one article, and I can't really cite any of them because I forgot everything. I didn't take notes or anything. I really, maybe as I start to do more of our communism, I'll definitely take more notes in my life, you know, moment to moment. I'm like, oh, that's really interesting. I'm going to cite that or take notes of that. I do carry my iPhone with me all around, so there's no reason I shouldn't be doing that. But anyway, there is this chart in one article I saw that shows over time the mergers that happened between banks. You know, in like 20 years ago, in America at least, so this is not a world chart, this is America chart. But it was like, there's all these banks, there's like 20 or different banks in 1980. And then like the chart moves in time. 1975, this bank buys this bank, merges with this bank. This bank buys this bank. So like Washington Mutual, which 7 years ago, that was my bank. That bank no longer exists. I'm currently, my bank currently is a Chase, JP Morgan Chase Bank, because JP Morgan bought Washington Mutual. And my account, in consequence, became Chase account. So it was describing how all these different banks started merging and merging and merging. Now we have a situation where it's like you can name a handful of banks that are the most powerful in America, and they have the most customers. It's like one bank has, you know, 30% of Americans as its customers. Something like that. It's become ridiculous. These banks have become really, really big and bloated, and they carry out so much loans. They have all these mortgages that are behind them, and so many people's accounts are under these banks. If one of these banks fail, it's a disaster. And that's pretty much why, time and time again, you know, banks know this. I guess I was reading an article in Rolling Stones that, like, it really went scathing into Bank of America. How Bank of American executives know the fact that they're too big to fail now. A lot of bank executives already know now that they're too big to fail. So they just do carry on with their unsustainable business practices and their loan shark ways of doing things. And they end up, you know, with what was once a profit, they end up losing so much amount of money. And they can't fail because, hey, they just go back to the government that feeds them and say, we need this much amount of money to get us out of the situation that we created. But if we can't get out of this situation, then all these people that use our bank will go bankrupt and go into poverty. And that will be a mass hysteria situation in American economics. So, yeah, the point is, banks have become way too big, and if they fail, it's going to be a major, major negative impact on society. And this is the picture that we're in, not only in America, which I was concerned with for the longest time, and now I'm actually starting to see that it's true for a lot of the other countries in the world. It's a scary picture to me. And the trend, it seems like, is not to fix it. It's not to make sure that this whole too big to fail is being solved. No, the trend seems to be that politicians and banks alike are just trying to hide what's going on, trying to make the regular people not know what's going on behind the scenes, that they are in fact utilizing the fact that they're too big to fail. They don't care. They know that they're too big to fail, and they're going to take advantage of it. It's like the world's worst moochers, you know. Like for example, there's always these kind of stereotypical characters in a novel or a movie or what have you. There's always this grown up like 30-year-old guy who is living in an apartment or somewhere. He doesn't pay his rent. He doesn't have a job. He just pretty much is a lazy guy who sits around at home, doing whatever, goes out, and goes to bars, and picks up women, and I don't know, there's whatever. He just does things. How does he pay for it? Well, he goes every weekend or so, he goes to his parents' home, and he asks them for money. And then, I thought of the perfect example. In How I Met Your Mother, Lily's dad is like the picture of that moocher. That's like the banks right now. Like, they have a hand that feeds them no matter what they do. And so they're taking advantage of that. And instead of trying to get out of this situation, banks are only trying to make sure that, for example, if I'm using Lily's dad as an example, Lily's dad is making sure that Lily doesn't find out. That's how the banks are acting right now. They're trying to do this behind the scenes. Like, you know, oh yeah, this is a horrible practice we're doing. We're loaning out securities that are not secure, that are poor crap, and kind of just gambling their money away all the time. And these are taxpayer money that they're using, but they're using their money and wasting their money. But they can't fail because they can always get more of that money from the government. But the fact that they're doing this, they're trying to hide that from the public, so that they don't get criticized or what have you, so that there isn't a massive outrage. And that's one of the reasons why there's such huge amount of protests and street marches going on, and especially in Europe, Although I guess Europe has many other issues such as unemployment and union busting and things like that. But all I can say is it's a pretty scary picture. I'm not an economist or anything, so I don't know how this situation would be fixed. But my thoughts are that if it continues going like this in this country and in the rest of the world, it's not a pretty picture what's ahead for us in the future. And that's my thoughts on the topic.